Hello there, everyone, and welcome back to the Great War mod. We're playing as the German Empire, and I've progressed a bit. What I've gone ahead and done is I've exempted every single region from tax, because I still make enough money from just the trade income. I make 61,000. No, I actually make more. I make 610,000, and the army upkeep is 11,000, giving me about 600,000 each turn, which is quite a lot. Then I've gone ahead and started trying to recruit some new armies and stuff, but they haven't really been finished just yet. We've got three armies in the west. We got this one right here, which hopes to deliver a crushing blow against the really the substantial leftovers of the French army that we got over here. We've got this one, which haven't really moved. I've gone ahead and set a general in charge of it. Kolmar Freiherr von der Goltz is in charge of it, and he's gonna deal with this. This is the newest army I'm building, which has all new troops, so it's a new rifle battalions. We've got a sniper group, we've got two flamethrowers, two machine guns, and we got one of the new rifle squadrons. We are also building, to add on to that, more infantry and two tanks, one A7V male tank and one female tank. We're still waiting for the factory here to be completed. It would take 24 turns, so that's still ongoing. We're building the navy as well in all my ports. We're building navy ships. In the east, we've got three armies as well. We got this smaller one under the command of Ludwig von Waldemoden Gibborn, and he's moving to Klausenberg, Transylvania, trying to take that. Then we got Ernst Heinrich Adolf von he is, I think this is the oldest general I have, or the first one I recruited. He is moving with his old army down towards Romania. And, oh, we've got this one. Sanders, Otto Lindemann von Sanders. And he will first go to Moscow, possibly pick up. We should probably start recruiting some new men for him. Actually, he's got a lot of infantry. How about some cavalry? And we will then take them up to Finland, hopefully. The only navy I've been able to take out or recruit is this one, which I moved here, which is all cargo ships. But I do believe that this force right here is just cargo ships as well of the British Navy. So we'll go ahead and attack them and see if we can't win there. But first, I'm going to try to advance through the forest here. There is a big chance of us being attacked on the way, I thought. The French force runs away. I want the new army to go ahead and attack, because I want to use them, especially the flamethrowers. I'm going to see about using them. Since the only move we have left, right, I was going to attack the British Navy, but we don't have any moves for that. So let's go ahead and end turn. Got a little aircraft coming around. Gonna go ahead and spy out what the French have in that region. Hopefully, maybe I'll get some bomber planes so I can bomb stuff. I have upgraded a lot of farms towards making them into airfields. Let's see. France is moving. Did they just raid that village? They might have. Oh, the Italians land in France. Reconnaissance plane in Brandenburg. So we get another reconnaissance plane. Huh, not too happy about that, but we'll send them to Denmark, because at some point we will attack Denmark and sort of make our ally Greater Sweden into a thing. So we need to know what's going on there. I thought it was an enemy. So we got one aircraft over here, we got one over here. Enemy raid. Oh, the poor little town. We got raided. We're building a whole lot of cities everywhere. And you will continue to try to chase down this French army. The rest of them, I guess, were so just destroyed after the fact that they were sort of stuck here, and I guess the French ran out of money to support them. So they just went away. Oh, look at this. There's basically nothing left, but that would make it a lot easier for me to use the flamethrowers. So let's go ahead and play this, because I want to use the flamethrowers. I should have used the autosave, because there's a little bit of a risk, of course, that it crashes when you use these highly modded weapons like the flamethrower. It's a shame the bloody bunkers destroy it, because the enemy likes to build them. I'm not entirely sure what exactly is the deal with the bunkers, but... Right, so we got the French up there. The general's unit only has 10 men in it. We're gonna have the infantry up front. Okay. Ah! Wait, who can spawn out there? It's the snipers. Can they... Yeah, the flamethrowers can hide out there as well. And they can actually hide in the tall grass. Interesting! Toggle grenade shot. Sure. How far can the snipers shoot? Oh, they can shoot from all the way. So if I got the snipers... We'll put them on this little hill here. And then the snipers can fire from here. From a concealed position. And then we'll have our infantry stationed back here with one machine gun set up right here. And one machine gun set up back there. In case. General over here. Cavalry unit. It's gonna be down there. This is the new cavalry. That got the helmet, the steel helmets. Good. Let's start the battle. Let's have the flamethrowers sneak through the forest and attack the enemy. The snipers have started to fire. Not like super keen on firing, it seems. Oh no, there they go. Go on then. Let's see, are they hitting anyone? Yes, they've shot two people. Maybe if they took a bit more time to aim, they would shoot some more people. What we need to do is we need to have these guys sneak in a way that they come around here and then, you know, unleash it into the side of this and the general's unit. Let's go ahead and speed this up, because otherwise it will take forever. With these guys slowly sneaking their way. The snipers, yeah, it's not a really super good position, is it, from over there? So, we will have the snipers instead move into the thicket here and fire from over there. And that should be a pretty good position, because they have a line of sight towards this unit that they were firing on, the second foot guards, possibly even these two smaller units. Flamethrowers are moving steady through the forest towards the flank there. Let's see, what unit are they firing at? They've shot one guy here. What are you doing now? Why are you moving like this? Fine, do whatever you want then. Oh yeah, you should actually move into the flank, shouldn't you? You can set up among these trees. Okay, the flamethrowers have moved there. So now we want them to move roughly over there. And then once they're discovered, I need to get them quickly into position and fire into the flank of this unit. At the same time, I think we need to mobilize these to be ready once the flamethrowers get started. These guys need to come up and then start firing through the main here. Let's go ahead and speed this up. So the attack is underway. Snipers slowly moving into their position in among these trees. Okay, the flamethrowers are close now. There's one flamethrower unit that's ahead of the other one. Here they come. It's a shame for their officer that he doesn't actually have a gas mask on. So that's going to possibly be a problem for him. Oh, they have been discovered. Halt! Use your flamethrowers! Here it goes! Okay, not... Don't use explosive shot. Or maybe use explosive shots. Oh, the French force is now charging forwards. This unit, they're still operational though. Forwards! Flamethrowers! I want to do the same the Russian did to me when they died. Just blew everything up. Let's see if these guys... Okay, they're throwing grenades. If you don't use the grenades, then... Set them on fire, damn you! Oh, I think they just... Yeah, there they go. They fire the flames. Go on, fire the flames, damn you! Fire the flames! Flames! Go on! What's taking so long? No! That unit did not survive. I want to see that close up though. Come on, just start. No! Ah, it's only the officer left. He's not going to set anything on fire. Ah. And then these guys. The foot guards, the French Foreign Legion. Was forced away. My flamethrowers. I shouldn't have used the explosive thing from the start. I thought you had to sort of enable that. The snipers keep sniping. Yes! You are back! But it's a bit late now. You're not going to be able not be that much use But that was cool. The fact that we set fire to... But they didn't set fire to that many. They set fire to these guys. As they were moving up. And they just... Whoop! Set everything on fire. Poor that guy that's standing over there. You can see all the bullets. Yeah. Just flying straight through him. Come on, get the... Where do I have my flames? Hurry up! Maybe it's not over yet for you. Maybe there's time to set some more stuff on fire. Hurry up, where are you? Cavalry! The general's unit. We could set him on fire. Here they come! The flamethrowers! Charging like mad across the open field. Stand. Charge over there and then flame through the side there. That should be... That should deter this unit from continuing to fire or fight. Hey, wait a minute. Isn't that those weird flamethrower guys? Shouldn't we shoot them? No, don't shoot them. Let them set you on fire! Go on. There we go. The flame! Didn't kill that many though. Boom. Get the other one. I want to see how many the flamethrowers got in the end. I don't think that got that many people. Get into the flank of this unit and set that one on fire as well. It looks cool though. But since there's a few in the unit, okay, hold fire a bit. I want to let the flamethrowers do their bit. No, don't run away. Fire the flames after them. Ah, they're gone. Well, hopefully we'll get to use that more. I should have... I should have checked how many they actually killed, the flamethrowers. Oh, wait, I can do it. This is where I do it. Let's see, flamethrowers. Flamethrowers killed. This one killed 7, this one killed 16, so yeah. Not great use of the flamethrowers. Plus, the 2 flamethrower units were destroyed in the process, so I'll have to recruit new ones. We'll recruit some new ones from this next turn. So I've done that. We've got this fight over here. These guys will continue forwards into this territory. You will continue down towards here. You will go to Moscow. And we got the fight against the French over here. This army can now move. So we can send that one off to attack Marseille. That's a good plan. And then we got this. But first I want to do the navy. Because I think the navy battle will be shorter. So we can relieve this port. Okay, so we've got Thomas Cochrane on the cargo ship Leviathan. And then the cargo ship Phoebe. And the Acheron. While we have the Arcona, Tiger, Vie, and the admiral ship of... I don't actually have an admiral, I should have recruited that. Right. Let's go ahead and out the save just beforehand. And then we'll go ahead and fight it. I have no clue how this is gonna look in terms of how the ships are, how much they've modded on them. Okay, so here we have the boats. It looks as though it's just the small type of sailing boats, just that they've put. And then there's some weird-ass cannons as well. Some really weird-ass cannons. It is the cannon, but it doesn't have a barrel. And the wheels, for some reason, are weird as shit. Okay. Here it is. No, advance like this. Full sail? Which one was the admiral ship? This one. So it looks kind of strange, and the captain as well is quite a few hundred years wrong in his uniform. But I bet that the British have a similar problem. Yes. So we do outnumber them in our amount of ships as well. Possibly. Oh, they fired. They took out 8 guns on this one. We're returning fire. We'll break the formation by going straight through it, hopefully. That's our hope. Oh, I think I might have fired on my own. We broke off part of their ship. We're gonna crash into this one. The ship in the back is gonna get isolated from the rest of them. Okay, now we need to turn around. You need to turn around. You need to turn around. And you need to turn around this way. So it looks as though we are winning. We've done heavy damage to the British ships. Although, oh, this one lacks its the middle mast. We took out the middle mast on this one as well. It looks a bit strange with the masts and stuff. Especially since they're turning like... We've got one of our ships that's been hit enough so it's actually sinking. That one is sinking. Okay, we've got 2 ships sinking now. The commander is going straight into that one. Fire the guns! The enemy admiral has been slain. Focus fire on the last ship. Oh, our admiral got hit pretty hard in the arse there. Swing around. It's a weird, like, steampunk. Oh, crap. I think that was actually our fire as we fired on this one, that some shots went through and hit that one. So, okay, well, we won the cargo ship fight, but everything exploded in the end. That was an interesting fight. We sunk all the enemy ships, and now this port is free, and hopefully, since it's recruiting some boats, they should be ready. We need to repair these. And then we'll give one of them an admiral. Right, yes, this fight now. A large fight. Sir! They retreat, so we split the force there, which allows us to attack this city on its own. Well, that's... They have a lot of good units here. No bunkers though, so a lot of cavalry. conscript battalion. Then we got Suave Light Foot, French Foreign Legion, three of those elite, and then they got four Polish, and they got two generals, Lorenz Murat and Ferdinand Foch. Let's go ahead and autosave, just in case, and let's fight it. Ferdinand Foch is defending against Gerhard von Scharnhorst. Horst. Gerhard von Horst is what I'm gonna call him. Hi, I'm an officer with all my body and soul, but I do not see how anyone who can see his dearest something. Right, so they go ahead and put their men in the city, which is a smart move. We're gonna set up our battery over here next to the road to make ease of access of the road. We've got the Alpenkorps, which I'm gonna set here, and then we've got the Finnish Jägers on the other side. And in the main, we have two waves of line infantry. Good. Let's go ahead and select the first wave of line infantry to advance and start this and start advancing on the town. On the flanks, we'll have the Finns and the Alpenjäger start moving forward towards the town as well on the flanks. Alpenjäger going into the forest on the left, while the Finns have a small forest here as they can advance towards the town. The 4th Foot Guards, French Foreign Legion, is under bombardment as shells fly all around. We will force them to surrender this city. We might have to destroy the entire city in the process, though. We've got a nice little train over there. We'll blow the entire thing to crap. But they've set up a lot of blockades here in the roads and stuff. And it's going to be hard to... the closer we get to town, and when we actually get into town and have to set up our men inside town, it's going to be difficult because they've got cavalry that could easily countercharge. And we do not really have anything that would easily... deter such actions by the enemy. Finns, we will set up over here. And the Alpenjäger will set up along here. So most likely what I'll do is I'll hold the Alpenjäger and the Finnish on the outside. And then we'll just have the infantry waves march up to attack. This one will go about there, but while the other one continues all the way into town. The shelling seems to be going just fine. Quite a lot of Frenchmen are falling victim to our bombardment. And soon the outskirts of this town will be ours. Let's go ahead and draw the lines. They will be drawn from the forest over there to about over there. Quickly, on the move now. Move to your position. Get the battalions up. We've got the 29th Regiment of Conscript, which is opening fire on the 42nd Regiment, the Rifle Regiment, but they will come under fire from the 13th as well as the 4th. We've got a charge by a crazy general. The 21st Regiment, however, is quick to seize the opportunity to slay the bastards. More enemy cavalry is advancing. Where is the... We need the backup wave to move into position quickly. The 29th Regiment is being destroyed. But we are also receiving heavy casualties. Where is the Alpenjäger? Are you in position? No, you are not. You two will hold right there and defend from within the forest, since the regiment of horse is moving up. There is a charge on the leftmost side of our... Oh, we blew up some of our own men there. Oh, crap. Keep it up, men. Our units are holding. But this one has suffered a lot. You will retreat immediately from the front. Cavalry coming in. But they're not charging, they're just slowly moving up and firing. Our left side has been hit very hard by the oncoming enemy attack. And they are forced to redraw. They're redrawing through friendly fire and they're getting murdered by it. Going better for the 35th, but the 4th Regiment was utterly destroyed. It's down to 15 men. The Alpenjägers have possibility to quickly move up a bit and set up in a better position in the forest. What's going on our right? There's a cavalry charge coming in. Colonial cavalry unit did manage to get in a flank charge on the 21st Regiment. The entire first line has suffered so heavily that they will redraw and they will be replaced by the reserves. Send up the reserves! The Finns will also move up to occupy part of the forest and supporting fire towards this Polish, the 13th Polish Regiment that is still holding on here. And fresh troops are being brought up to the front line, ready to smash through the French. It's only the Polish who are doing a rear action here, trying to protect against the remnants of the French army retreating. Let's see how long this rear action by the 13th Regiment of the Poles will hold on. General is retreating. Heavy fire. Now every fire from our army is going down towards this Polish regiment, which is now slowly advancing for some reason. It's slowly advancing into the fire. And it's getting utterly destroyed. And there we have it. I want cease fire. Hold your fire. Both enemy generals were killed. 41 of that Polish unit will be able to get out of here alive. But look at this carnage as we look across the field here. So many Frenchmen, so many Germans as well. But the Germans held steadfast and fell on their positions. I was in complete slaughter, but I mean, my victory was pretty, pretty given, so just to make something that would look cool. We've got even some French died all the way in here. I guess it's stray bullets that fly through the air, hitting them all the way back there. But the amount of corpses here is staggering. Mechanized warfare. Even though we... The only thing we used of mechanized warfare was the artillery. Terrific victory. I lost enough men to make it a terrific victory. I wonder if America's come kind of join in. They haven't yet, and I... It was a long time since I actually went into Belgium and took care of them. We lost 1,200 men, but the French force lost every single soldier. The Picardie-Champagne region has been secured. And now we've got opportunity to build another harbor. Right, the aircraft will go ahead and stalk this army. Infiltrate the airspace. And he was successful, and now we've got complete knowledge of what's going on there. We got the Italian forces turned up. The Italians bring with them bunkers. Idiots. I do not like bunkers, but I am recruiting more new troops. If we can keep the Italians away, but I don't think we will keep them away. We got Ruhr Assault Infantry. And we got some Guard Infantry. I have yet to be able to recruit any of my own submachine gunners, but I bet that's going to come. National Military... Stormtroopers, Rifle Grenadiers, Trench Gunners. We can also soon build... What we need is a military base instead of the military academy, I think. The military base will be able to do some nice stuff for us. We'll have to increase the autonomy in that region. This army is, should be going back there, and then we can bring the tanks, and the first one that will take tanks is Denmark. Unfortunately for little Denmark. You continue your march over there. We need to see what the Russians do have in this region. What do you have here? What... this army have a load of different sharpshooters and snipers, and then Czechoslovakian troops, and then they got more sharpshooters out there. I got the Austrians to declare war on Russia again. Yes, I did, but they're not too keen on actually achieving my orders. At the same time, we'll infiltrate the space above Bucharest, and we'll see what the Romanians have. They've got an artillery piece, light hussars, elite infantry battalions, and then they got a force here waiting for Ernst to turn up. Right. What are we researching? A load of stuff. And hopefully that will come a lot of aerial doctrines and stuff. Close air support is being under... And then we've got aerial combat, bombing operations, aircraft carriers, But we also got stuff like suffrages of women. So women will be able to vote in 2 turns. In 2 months, women will be able to vote. We also got diesel engines on the way. Women have already been put to work, which was one of the first things I did to increase the wealth. The wealth of the regions should be stabilizing right now because it totally shrank to nothing. However, it's not gaining that much. 52 per turn, even though they're paying no tax whatsoever. But still, it's that low. Brandenburg is pretty happy, so I think we can build a factory here as well. Even though it'll take 24 bloody turns. Right, looking at the time, however, we're gonna end it right here. So for the next turn, we're hoping that we should be able to attack Denmark. We'll continue the war against France, and also Romania and Transylvania will probably fall. And maybe some of the navy will be ready, so we can continue our war and attack Finland and claim that. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoy this, and hopefully I'll see you guys for the next one. Bye.